Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be doing another episode on Myth of Empires. Today we're going to be doing a guide on how to tame and breed horses. And we're basically just going to explain everything about horses, how to tame them, how to breed them, and what you're looking for when you're doing that. There are some lovely horses for us to tame here, however they're quite high level and I feel like I should probably go to where the sort of starting area is and go for some lower level horses just to give you guys an idea of how it works. So yeah, basically we're going to go ahead and jump into that in a second. But first off, the main thing that you want to build before you go and tame horses is you want to look for coarse rain and coarse dry fodder, and you want to build both of these things. And generally, you want to have, if it's your first time taming a horse, you want to have, I'm doing the wrong thing, probably 10 to 20 dry coarse fodder. Now, you shouldn't need that much, but it's always better to have more than you need. But I think you unlock this stuff at level 12 or 14? 14. So at level 14, you'll unlock tamed horse, which will give you the coarse reins and dry fodder. Dry fodder is just grass and bark. It's quite simple, quite easy to make. And the coarse reins just need a bit of hide, but it's essentially the same thing. Just a bit of straw rope and branch. Very, very simple and easy to make. So yeah, what you want to do is, I'd say, probably have two coarse reins if you're not used to taming the horse, because if you get kicked off them a lot, they can break quite quickly. And like I said, probably, yeah, somewhere between 10 to 20 dry coarse fodder, which shouldn't take too long to make. And then once you have that, you can jump in and go and tame yourself a nice little horse. So essentially what you're looking for, and you won't really know this, this is more for the breeding side of things, but we're just going to run through the basic info of the horses here, just give you a quick rundown. So essentially when you're starting the game, HP, what you want to be looking for is a horse with somewhere between 2,000 to 3,000 at the easy starting level of the game. Torpidity is how much your horse can get hit before it goes unconscious, and I think you can tame them. I've never done it, but I believe you can also tame them whilst they're unconscious to make it easier, but I think it just takes a bit longer. And yeah, I think you can also level them up more when they're unconscious, because you can force feed them food, which increases their obedience but also gives them a certain amount of experience. I think we'll have a look at that a bit later. Stamina, yep, you want somewhere that's around 130 to 150 for your low level horses, but that is just, you know, how far your horse can go in a single direction. Max speed is pretty self-explanatory. It's just how fast your horse can go at its max movement. Maneuverability is just how your horse moves left and right, and how it can turn, how quickly it can turn. So again, you would want one that's probably around 200 to 300 for maneuverability, but I don't think it matters too much. It's just if you need to be able to turn quickly, or if you're using it as a war horse and you want to be able to change directions fast, then that can, you would want that to be a lot higher. Fullness doesn't really matter. That is just how much food your horse can hold, essentially, or how long until you need to feed it. Then most of them will be roughly the same, around 100 to 120, so that doesn't really matter. Any higher is probably better, but essentially it doesn't matter as long as you keep it fed. Carry weight, you'll be looking for something around 500 to 600. I feel like this is, for the level horse I have, it's quite low carry weight of 700, but it's pretty good at the same time. But that's just how much your horse can hold inside of it, and your weight is also accounted into that, I believe. Well, it should be. Health is quite an important one. So I know we have HP here, which is the horse's overall health and how many hit points it has. So health is actually a lot more important. As you can see, it's 112, so it's very different to HP. But essentially what it does is, it's like the life force but less severe. So as your horse gets hurt, or as it gets hungry and you aren't feeding it, the health will start to go down. And as its health starts to go down, all of its stats here, everything, its max speed, its carry weight, its stamina, torpidity, all of these things will start to deteriorate and go down. And until if your horse health gets to zero, then it can seriously impact your horse or even kill it. So yeah, and the way to fix this is by feeding it fodder. and any fodder works. Obviously, the better fodder you can make, the better, but fodder like this, dry coarse fodder, is fine. You can put that in here and it will increase its health, but you can't increase its health by just grass alone, I don't think, once it starts to go down, but it won't go down until it's been like severely hurt. But that is just something you need to be, keep an eye on. If your horse starts moving slower or it feels like it can't carry as much, then it's probably worth checking its health to make sure that that is full and at its most. Impact force is essentially, it's how much the horse can hit before it slows down. So it's lower the speed reduction when the mount rams an enemy. So essentially, when your horse rams against the target, the impact force, if you have a high impact force, what it means is it's less likely your horse will be stopped once it hits that enemy. And if the higher the impact force, it means the more likely your horse is just going to drive straight on through the enemy rather than stop it. If it's a low impact force, you would probably just stop dead on the target and they'll be able to take you out. It's life force. So all horses that you tame will have different levels of life force. Generally, I think the most common one is around 600. Obviously, my horse has died a couple times and I've also bred it. So that's why my life force is down. If you breed horses, their life force deteriorates, even if you aren't successful at breeding. Every time that you mate them, the life force will start to drop. I think it drops by 20 points, I think. But it might be more than that, actually. I'll have a look. But yeah, it will drop every time. And every time your horse dies, its life force will also drop down quite significantly. And the longer it takes for you to revive them, so I think every hour it will drop a certain amount of points. So if you don't revive them straight away, their life force will continue going down until you eventually revive them. And then once it gets to zero, that's it. You can't revive it unless you're in the late game and you can produce the potions, which then increases its life force. So essentially what you want to do is, if you have a very, very good horse, you want to station it in the stables and keep it there so that it's safe and it isn't going to get killed off. So I'd always suggest to breed them and always keep your best horses, your best female and male horses in the stable at all times, and always use the foals if you can, so that you keep them too alive as best as you can. But yeah, that's all of the stats. And then we have our talents, traits, weaknesses and inheritance. All horses will generate different talents and traits. They're pretty much the same thing. It's just will be different attributes compared to these. So vitality will mean more health, so as you can see, it ups our health, but it also decreases our movement speed and obedience gain slightly there. And then we've got warhorse adaptability, which is an increase in speed and obedience but a decrease in stamina and I want to say carry weight, but that does look a bit weird. I think that is carry weight. So it decreases those by 1 point, but increases speed by 3 and obedience by 1. And then we've got charger attribute. So health goes up by 12, which is a massive, massive bonus, and everything else drops down by 1. And obviously, these are almost all of them blue. This is because this is quite a high-level horse when I tamed it. It's had no training done. So these are quite good attributes for it. Most other horses will just have a few greens. So we've got all of these other ones here that all affect different things. I mean, we've got much higher numbers here, -4, +2, -4, +10, 10 movement speed, which is really, really good. But the main things we want to look at here are the weaknesses, which is unwilling to communicate, which gives us all negatives on the health, stamina, and obedience. Now, weaknesses can be brought on and taken care of. So if you do any horse training, which is essentially horse training is having an AI character in your stable, and then you pay him hourly rates to train up your horses. Now, horse training can either alleviate a weakness and get rid of it, or it can actually create a weakness. By giving your horse so many levels, it can actually bring in new weaknesses or get rid of the old ones. So if you do have a really bad weakness, it might be worth doing some extra horse training to get rid of it, but you also have to be aware that it can also bring in a new one instead. So it is quite it's a risk. But you can get rid of them, it's not impossible. And then inheritance is, so obviously the first horse you tame isn't going to have any inheritance. That is all to do with breeding. So if I took my two horses, bred them together, then the new horse would gain a random set of some of these traits and talents. But they'd come up down here, so it'd still have its own talents and traits, but it would have its inherited talents and traits. So it would just have more talents and traits, essentially, compared to a bog standard horse. That's all. So I think that is everything that we need to really go through there. Except for this, we also have, here a quality rating wheel. So to get a good grasp of how good your horse actually is, it gives you a literal number figure right here. So mine is 61.7 out of 100, which for the early game is pretty good. And as you can see, we have a blue stat here in the health section, meaning that my horse is generally very good in its health compared to anything else. So as you get later on in the game, these things will all start going blue, and then they'll start going different colours beyond that. But this just gives you a good idea of what your horse is actually good at. So if you wanted a good war horse, you'd probably want movement speed and health, or maybe health and stamina. If you want a good workhorse, you'd just kind of want a lot of carry weight and movement speed, I imagine, something along those lines. So it just gives you an idea of what you can really use them for, because all horses have their uses. But I think that's it. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on. I'm going to skip ahead, and we're going to jump down to the fields where we're going to show you how to tame a horse. We're going to go through that, and then we're going to breed them, and I'll show you through that. So I'll see you guys in a second. All right, guys. Hi, welcome back. We've made it over to where the horses are. We got chased by a panther along the way, which was very fun. But essentially, we're behind the city here, but it doesn't matter. Anywhere in these sort of plains areas, all the way from the coast, all the way up to the city, except for just this central spine where the mountain is, you'll find horses scattered all over the place. Around the city, you'll tend to find around level 30s, whereas over here, it will be more sort of level 20s and below, or in like the teens to 20s. They'll spawn over here. But over here, generally, it's the level 30s, and obviously, as the further back you go, around here you'll get sort of level 50s, 60s. Around here, it'll be level 40s to 50s. Just the further back you go, the higher the level. But around the city, level 30s, still pretty easy, even if you're just starting out to do. Probably going to spook this one. Yeah, we're a little bit close there. Should have been paying more attention. But essentially, what we're going to do is we're just going to see if we can find one. It is. Best to do it, I mean, they're all over the place and I'm spooking them all. It is best to do it when you have open playing ground and you're definitely not near any sort of vagrant settlements at all. I mean, there's one over there we could have a look at grabbing. As you can see, they're mostly all in the 30s. And generally, if you spook one and it runs towards another one, it will spook the other one. It doesn't necessarily have to be you, so you do have to sneak up on them and be quite careful about how you approach them. Probably best not to do what I'm currently doing and ride around on a horse. It definitely doesn't help. If we just have a brief look, there'll be plenty around. Again, like I said, we kind of want to avoid these places because they'll just distract, spook, or hurt the horse. So we don't want to do it around any places like that. And generally, like I said, you want to find a nice open bit of ground. It's not nice to do it in the woods at all. I'm sure we'll find one in a second. There's one over there. We'll go for that one. Doesn't matter what level it is. So I would say we'll probably stop about here. And what we want to do is we want to grab out our coarse dry fodder. And we want to grab our coarse reins as well in the other hand. So you can dual wield them. So we've got level 31 there. And we've got level 23. So quite significantly different levels. Now what we want to do is we want to throw the dry coarse fodder away from us and just over the horse. So he'll start going towards that. They're both going to run towards it. Because we threw it closer to him, he's going to go and grab it. Now we might spook this one, or he might turn away. So he's turned away, but as you can see, our horse, the level 31, is currently busy eating the dry coarse fodder. So what we're going to do is we're just going to sneak up to him. We don't have to crouch, we can walk. He won't spook, his friend might, but we don't want to spook the friend because sometimes he can spook R1. But as you can see, we walk up to it, it comes up with the option to press E to mount. Now we want to go ahead and we want to do that. And as you can see here, we've got four different bars. We've got our obedience bar at the top, which is filling, and that's essentially our tame bar. So once that's full, the horse is ours. We have our anger bar, which essentially is just going to fill up over time. Depending on the horse's level, it will fill up quicker or slower, doesn't really matter. But essentially, once it gets to the end, the horse is going to go angry. It's going to get mad, and it's going to try and boot you off it. And I'm going to show you what that looks like, but essentially you just have to do a series of left clicking and right clicking in order to stay on the horse. If you're successful, you just get to carry on taming. If you're unsuccessful, you get kicked off. Your rein loses a bit of health, but you don't actually lose any progress. It just means you have to wait to carry on taming it. Essentially, the horse will be angry for like a minute or two, and then you have to do that again with the coarse fodder and then jump on its back again. But as you can see, our obedience bar is going up very quickly. That is just because I have a very high taming level. So my obedience goes up a lot quicker in comparison to if you're just starting out, it'll go up a lot slower. We have our wild level, and that is related to the anger level. So once the anger level maxes out, it'll have a wild level, and that's the left and right clicking. So the more you click left when it says, the less the wild level will go up. What you don't want it to do is get to the top, because that's when it kicks you off. So you just want to keep it as low as possible. And if you're successful in doing that angry bit, then it just the wild level just resets, goes to zero. The anger will go about halfway and then carry on from there. And then we have our ranking, which is just self-explained. It is just a ranking. It doesn't actually matter. So it is just how well you are taming the horse. I think what it actually translates to is how many obedience points you're putting into it. So currently I've put in 1,700 points into its obedience bar. And if you get perfect, it doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to get the horse once it reaches perfect. It just means you've got a perfect score. But it's all to do with ranking and how many experience points you get for taming the horse. But here we go. It's about to go berserk. So we're just going to have to rapidly left click, rapidly right click, rapidly left click. And it will just do this a few times over. Getting quite close there, and there we go, we've done it perfectly first time. We've got a perfect ranking score, and I was going to cut this out, but as we're pretty much there, we may as well just see it through to the end, or maybe I'll cut it out. It's only going to take a couple more seconds and it'll be done, and we'll tame the horse. But it is pretty self-explanatory. I am just letting the horse pick its own direction, but if you build like a little trap because you're possibly quite close to wolves or panthers or wherever, or if you've got any threats in the area, you can actually direct the horse by going left and right. You can't slow it down or speed it up, but you can actually go left and right. So if you build like a little stable of your own, you can direct the horse to go into it. So I can drive him straight into this wall if I wanted. I can keep him here if it helps me, but there we go. We've tamed the horse, level 31. Just click confirm, we don't need it. So all we need to do now is essentially, you just unlock the, you unlock the, saddle. You unlock the saddle, which gives you 5 inventory slots. It's not very hard to make, it's just 6 horse hide, 2 rope, and 4 bark. You build that in your inventory, you put it on the horse, just in that slot there. It will unlock 5 of these bars for you. That's 4. 5 of these bars for you. And then you get those extra inventory slots, and now you can ride the horse. But as you can see, level 31, it's given us about 2,500 health. A max speed of 729, which isn't bad. You want around 750 to 800, ideally. So 729 is not bad at all. Generally, its stats there are quite good. It's got 600 life force, which is good. It's got 2 blue talents. Good movement speed. We can have a look at its overall rating. So 57 is not bad at all. Again, it's very focused on health, just like our current one. So if we wanted a horse with amazing health, we could breed these two together. And that would probably give us quite a good one. The only issue is now I've got to find... Oh, wow. Ended up perfectly next to my old horse. There we go. Look at that. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That is quite simple. We've got permission. So, wow, didn't mean to do that. So if we just go into the permissions there, we can change who can ride it, who can open its inventory, who can call it, and who can breed it, essentially. You can change all of these just there. You can set it to follow, or you can set it to wander. If it's on wander, I think, I haven't tested this yet, but I think it can produce its own food. So it will just go to bushes and things and eat for itself. So you can do that. If you've got quite a large base or like a very long wall around an area, you can just set your horse to wander and then it should feed itself. But yeah, I'm yet to test that to make sure that actually works. But I'm pretty sure it does. So yeah, you can just have it wandering. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Wander, follow, open inventory. And I'm not going to keep this one at all. So essentially, to get rid of a horse, you have... That was weird. So yeah, I currently have two out. So to get rid of one, you just click this top bar here, and it gives you these four options. So you have execute, which kills it, but doesn't get rid of it. So execute will kill it and put it in the stable, which I'll show you in a minute how that works. I could do that now. No, that's fine. So yeah, what we're going to do is we're going to go for dismiss. Now that will just wipe the horse out completely. So that will kill it and also get rid of it for me, so it can't be revived. That will just get rid of it completely. But we can also sterilize it, which means it can't be mated. I don't think there is any benefit to sterilizing. I just think it means you can't mate them anymore. I can't think of an instance where I'd need to do that, to be honest. I honestly don't think there is a benefit to that, but there might be. I might be wrong there. And then pedigree. Pedigree is all to do with genealogy, traits, talents. And to be honest, I'm not 100% up to it. I'm going to have to do a video on that later when I know a little bit more about it. But yeah, you have these trees here, which just pedigree the horses. I think they make, I'm not 100% sure on how that works just yet, but I'm going to have a look into it just after this video, and then I'll do something on that afterwards. So you guys know as well, if you don't already. If you do know, please let me know. But yeah, to just get rid of a horse, you just simply click dismiss, and it releases the horse from your inventory. Please God, tell me I did the right one. I did. Thank God for that. So there we go. That gets rid of the horse for us. So it's now gone. No longer exists. So yeah, it's pretty simple. We only used one dry fodder for that. I know I said 10 to 20. That's only if you're not used to it. You just want to make sure you have enough. But you really don't need that much. But and again, also I said that my taming level is not ridiculously high. It's 281. So it's not massively, massively high. But it does give me a 55% increase in obedience gain, so that is quite significant compared to when you're just starting out. Yeah, it's not too bad. Right, we're going to go ahead, jump back to the camp, and I'll show you the stables and the breeding. See you guys in a second. Hey guys, and welcome back. So here we are at our stables. So stables are pretty straightforward, pretty easy to build. You have to build them in the architect's bench. They cost a little bit of copper ore, copper ingot, but they're generally not too difficult to create. I can't remember the exact amount. But to put your horse in it, you essentially just hold E on it and click here, place your horse in the stable, and then just click on your horse, and your horse will transfer into there immediately. Before we go into it, if you have a recruit or anyone you want to use, I hope you like my door. I thought it was very, very nice. Essentially, yeah, if you want to put a guy inside of it to train your horses, all you need to do is bring them over to the actual stable itself. So we'll get this guy. He's not an actual tamer. And essentially, all you need to do, hold E on it, and then assign warrior to work, and then click on your character, and it will come up the options. I'm not going to do it because there is currently a bit of a history of it glitching out at the moment. And what happens, now this doesn't happen to everyone, but it does happen to me, and I've lost a couple of characters to it. It once you train a horse with your guy, sometimes your character essentially doesn't exist anymore. So as much as he'll be sat here doing work on the stables, you won't be able to train any more horses or remove that character from the stables anymore. And essentially, yeah, it just kind of it glitches out. I know they're aware of it and they are currently fixing it. Whether they have or not, I don't know. So I'm just not going to put him in there at the moment because I don't want that to happen. But I know they are fixing it. And I'm getting on that, so it shouldn't happen too much more, or if at all. So essentially what you want to do, in your stable inventory, you want to have as much food as possible. So I've got a lot of random crap in here at the moment. It's just because I've just built this house and I don't have much storage. But you want to fill it up with as much food as you can, really. Grass and fodder. Now I have a nice mix of grass and fodder in here. Fodder because, one, it increases the experience of all of my horses, and also if they have any low health, then it'll also increase that as well. So it's quite handy for multiple reasons. Plus, it does increase a lot of fullness compared to grass. So it's just nice to have a good mix. It means that the horses are going to be looked after for a longer period of time without me having to look after them, especially as I have four at the moment. Breeding. That's what we're moving on to. So to breed horses, obviously, you want a male and a female. I have three males, one female, and she has been used to breed a couple of times. I've only been successful one of those times, which is why I have a horse called Horse, which I'm going to use the clip from when this bred, because I don't reckon if I mate these two, they're going to be successful again because they created this one. So I don't reckon, as I haven't tried it yet, that they'll be successful twice in a row. If that does happen, it's incredibly lucky, but I don't reckon it will. But I did get the clip of when this horse came in and was growing, so I can show you that and show you what it looks like. But essentially, to breed horses, all you need to do is click mate down here, and then just click your female and one of your males, and it will do horses mating. A bit of a poor translation, but you get the gist of what it means. And then you just click confirm. You'll get an hour timer. They'll mate, and then the male will go into cooldown, and the female should just produce a horse down here. And it will just have a normal picture. It will be called Horse, and instead of normal, it will just have growing. But like I said, I've got the clip, so I'll drop that in here afterwards. Anyway, what else have we got? In the stables, we've got this little thing up here, and this is where you resurrect any of your horses that have died. So, yeah, if you're out and a panther just randomly jumps at you, kills your horse will turn up down here with its little name. And it'll have a timer saying how long until it loses its next life force point. And all you need to do is simply click on the horse and then click on recover down here. If its life force is completely gone, then you just click bury if you don't have any elixirs to add life force to it. And in the early stages, you won't have any of those elixirs because they're very difficult to come by. But apart from that, the only other thing you can really do in a stables is retrieve or train. And to horse train, obviously you need a character, a trainer, to be in here. I think you can put multiple trainers on a stable, so you don't just have to have the one. But yeah, you simply just pop him in here. It'll come up. You click on him. It will tell you how much it's going to cost. You just click on that. And then the other thing to consider is to make sure that he has a lot of food in his inventory. And essentially, the higher the taming skill of your character is, not your character, sorry, your AI, your slave, I guess, the higher his taming skill, the more efficient he will be at training the horse. So the more levels he'll be able to add onto it, and the more attributes he'll be able to improve. But it also does increase the cost. And it can take quite a long time. Obviously, you can bring that up and down. At the moment, it is a little bit glitchy, and I don't think it moves. It kind of just sometimes just sits at that time. But you can change the time. But sometimes it can be a bit funny. But otherwise, I think that's it. I will roll a clip for the breed. I think I cover a few points in there as well. I might be going over a couple of points I've already gone over, possibly. I can't remember. But I'll show you the clip of when the horse did come through. And that is it, really, guys, for the episode. That's pretty much it. So there's not a whole lot else you can do for your horses. Obviously, we've got the armors. We've got light and heavy armors, but they're pretty self-explanatory. If you want a faster horse, you pick light armor. If you want a heavier but more armored horse, so if you're using something like a sword and shield or a two-handed weapon, you'd probably go for heavy armor for a horse, especially if you're using it as a war horse. Whereas if you're just using it as a workhorse, you'd much rather go for light armors, which is what I choose to wear most of the time. Just keeps movement speed up as much as possible. Apart from that, let's just enjoy the view. I will roll the clip and I will see you. Nope, not going to do that yet. Yeah, I will roll the clip. So, see you in a second. As you can see here, I managed to get a clip earlier on where we've had a baby horse. Unfortunately, we've missed the initial part, but essentially you don't really see much. After the timer has finished, the horse will just pop up here at the bottom of your list. And then what will happen is, essentially it will say growing and it will require a lot of food. And as you can see, we haven't got any in there at the moment, so we'll just pop some in. and it'll start absolutely flying down. But when the horse is very little, it has absolutely no health at all. So as you can see, this has only just recently been born, as it has a max of 70 health, and its fullness is also tiny. It's only got 2.4, so it's going to need a lot of food in order to grow it. But it's also adopted its parents' traits, or at least some of them. So we now have a weakness. Interesting. So yeah, I think some of these may have carried over to our new friend. Might not have been his ones, possibly. No, I don't think they have, actually. I think we have to do the pedigree. Oh, they're up here at the top, right, I see. So yeah, there's the inheritance. Sorry, I'm just being stupid. It's right in front of me. So we'll unlock these skills later on in the horse's life as it levels up, and these will start to take an effect on the horse. But it, yeah, gets inheritance of all the skills of its parents. I was just being stupid there. But yeah, essentially what you want to do is put as much food into your stables as possible. We don't have a whole lot at the moment. We do need a lot more. Flowers are good. But what you really want to do is not use grass or flowers or any of that. What you really, really want to use when you're growing a brand new horse is anything that adds its experience, like common course fodder, and anything along those lines. So I think you can make some really good stuff in the mortar and pestle. If we just quickly go onto the crafting recipes here. Yeah, we've got things like high quality course fodder, which increases XP by 46 every time it's consumed. So if you keep putting that into the stables, not only will it affect your new horse a lot, it'll also affect all of the others that eat from that food, and it'll increase the experience of those horses as well. And as you level up, you obviously get better versions of these. I'm only at the second one, and I haven't made any in preparation for this horse because I wasn't really expecting to do it. I just thought, as I had a bit of time to kill, I would put them to mate and see if I could produce a new one. As you can see, we've got some semi-decent levels here, and so yeah, I thought I'd give it a go. We've got another male, but ultimately I think his stats aren't too bad. His health going up quite quickly already. Yeah, I should probably get some better stuff to put in there with him. But yeah, essentially that's what's going to happen when it's over, and yeah, we'll get on to the other stuff. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed that. Yep, that's pretty much it for the horses. How to breed, how to tame them. There's a lot of things we'll be covering, so we'll be talking about the pedigree, but I'll also try and do a video on covering the different levels of horses, because we have not just the normal levels of horses, the bog standard ones, but we also have fine horses and heavenly horses. Obviously found in different sections of the map, but I'll cover those in another video later on. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you've got any comments, suggestions, tips, or just anything you want to say or let me know, or if there's any guides you want to see or any videos, then please let me know down in the comments below, or go ahead and message me on Discord as well. And you can send me a private message on there and I will get back to you as quickly as I can. But yeah, generally if you have any questions or anything like that, please do let me know. Make sure you subscribe as well if you haven't already. It just supports the channel out and it keeps you updated with all of the other content that we'll be bringing out onto it, all the other guides and whatnot, and yeah, just general stuff. But yeah, otherwise guys, I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope it's helped. I hope it's answered any of the questions you may have had. I know I struggled with some of those issues myself, especially I didn't know initially where to revive my horse, so it was quite handy that somebody showed me that, because I found three of them in there. I don't know why I didn't realize it sooner. It was quite simple, but it's just one of those things that you just miss and you don't really think about to check for. But yeah, otherwise guys, I hope you've enjoyed and I'll see you in the next episode. Hope you have a good one. Goodbye.